So once we've saved this document we've created in Legal Server, we want to go ahead and, of course, do the actual mapping of our merge fields. So to do that, you'll go up to your Actions menu, and you want to find the link called Edit Fields. This is going to launch you into the process for mapping your template. The first thing you have to do is confirm with the system which fields are your mapping fields. So you'll notice everything on this deselected side is corresponding to everything we had in the square brackets on our RTF here. Now, the reason for this step is in case you had something in square brackets within your template that was not actually a merge field, you wanted it to just stay as is, you would leave it over on this deselected side, and then it wouldn't be overwritten by any sort of mapping or anything like that. It would just stay as is. But of course, all of these truly are mapping fields for us, so we're going to select them all, use our right arrow, and move them over to that selected side. I'll then press continue here. And our next step is called the actor step. And by actor, we really mean where are we pulling information from in Legal Server. So the first step here is to select either matter, which means cases, or user. The reason we have this initial step, it's actually a fairly new step here, is because we added the option to download templates from a user profile. So just like we can download a template from a case, we can also do that from a user. So if this were one of those cases where we wanted to download something from the user, we would switch this, of course, to user. But because our template here is a case template, which again, most templates will be, we want to click save. And that's going to reload with the list of our case-related actors here in the dropdown. Oh, and there's a question. Is there a way to create a template letter and have the ability to choose the office letterhead? Because we have 8 offices over 12 counties that may want to use the same form letter. So for that, you would have to have a separate document template in Legal Server for each of those. They would essentially, of course, be the same exact template, just with a different letterhead. And you could use the fields on the document profile to select which one should show up for what case. So you can use the offices as well as counties to decide, you know, which template should show up for which type of case. But you would have to have a separate document template for each. Unfortunately, you can't just choose your letterhead, you know, while you're downloading the template from the case. All right, great. So as I mentioned, we've got our dropdown now of all of our case-related actors here. The most important actor to point out is this case information actor. I'm going to go ahead and select it and click my Add button. So we select, or so we add it to the template. Now the case information actor is probably going to be the only actor that you'll need for 90-95% of the templates that you'll want to build. You've got a ton of information in this actor, things like the client name, the case ID, problem code, primary assignment name, again, pretty much all of the basics that most programs tend to pull into their templates. The reason that you would have to select a different actor, an additional actor, is if you need very specific information about generally a person on the case. So for instance, if we needed really detailed information about our primary assignment, so if we needed something like his email address instead of just his name, we would select that and add that actor as well. The big thing to note about your person actors is that while they are named generally, and it is a lookup, so you may have a little bit of a different naming convention for your actors, but generally they're named like this. So this one is named primary assignment, and then in parentheses person, because that's the type of actor that it is. But it's a little bit misleading because the system really does not know that you want to pull in the primary assignment until you choose your default type here on the actor. So of course, here is where I would choose assignment primary, and I'm telling the system that's who I want to pull information from. Now you'll notice we have a couple of these fields for each of our actors. Those are only relevant if we are using that begin process. So if we use the begin process, and for instance, we might have two primary assignment actors, or apologies, that one would not make too much sense. We can only have one primary per case. But if we had two pro bonos that we wanted to pull into our template, we might have two pro bono assignment actors added. And we would, of course, then use these fields to tell us which actor we're looking for. So once we've added the actors that we need, of course, we don't actually need this person actor for our test template. Again, a very basic one, but I'm going to leave it on there just so you can see what having an additional actor will look like on our next step. All right, so our third step here is the actual mapping step. So this is where we're telling Legal Server, client name is, you know, the same thing as the client name in Legal Server. We're actually mapping the two together. Of course, you'll notice we have all of our merge fields over here on the left, and the right is going to show us all of our available fields to map to from the actors that we've chosen. So right up at the top is where I would change actors. So if I did need to use this primary assignment actor, I could do that. Again, this is where I would see things like their email address, their fax, all of those things to map to. But if I jump back to my case information actor, this is where we're going to find all of the things we need for this template. You could go ahead and start opening up menus and looking for the fields that you want. I happen to know that the client name field, the full name is just called name, and it's under my client's menu there. So I can go ahead and find that. Basically just click on that field and drag it all the way back up. And I'm going to drag it to the actual field, the merge field that I want to link it to. And you'll notice that when I get close to that field, it actually completes the chain linking and turns green. So that's how I know it's about to link there. And when I drop it, it will stick there for me. So I can see, of course, my client name is stuck there to my client name merge field. Now, the other way that you can find the merge fields that you're looking for is by using the keyword box at the top. That's generally what I typically do when mapping templates. It's definitely the quickest way, unless you happen to know exactly where the field you are looking for lives. So for our next one, case ID, I'm going to type in ID. And I'll see down here in this case menu that I've got a matter case ID. Next, we've got problem code. So I'll start typing in problem. And again, under our case menu here, we've got a legal problem code field. And then lastly, we've got our primary assignment. So we want the primary assignment's name. Now, a common thing that I might search for in my keyword box would be assignment, but I'll notice that I see an assignment type and a list of all assignment names, but that's not exactly what I want here. So if I get rid of that and instead try to use the word primary, I'll notice that I get the primary advocate pop-up here. So that's just a note that sometimes you'll have to search on a couple of different words to find what you're looking for. That's something where, you know, our ability, our flexibility in the naming of our merge fields is great when we're building the template. But when we get to this step, it can make it a little bit harder to find the field we're looking for. But again, I assure you, 90% of the fields that you'll want to find are within this case information actor. So I would always suggest just to use a couple of different keywords until you find what you're looking for. Again, we'll bring this over and link it there. Now, once we've linked all of our merge fields, we'll notice that the fields are 4 out of 4 at the top here. So we know that we've caught all of them. They're all linked, and we can see their chain linkings are complete. So I'm going to go ahead and click continue here, which brings us to our last step of the mapping, which is simply showing you what you're mapping to. So we can see our merge field name from our documents, the legal server field name connected to it, and of course the actor that those are coming from. Now we'll click continue, and it will bring us right back to our document profile. This is again where we can make any changes if we needed to our criteria here, or whatever we had to do.